Me and my dad are back at Dr. Now's for my second appointment. The last time I was here, I was 718. That was 3 months ago, because I had to take an extra month with everything that happened with my dad. So if I made it to my goal today, it'll mean I'm at least below 598. That number is extremely disappointing to see. It's a loss, but not nearly what I thought it would be, or where I needed to be. So all I basically did was bring my dad all the way here to show him that I failed. So I'm feeling embarrassed and really discouraged right now. And I'm scared because I don't know what Dr. Now is gonna say.
Hello.
Hello.
How y'all doing?
All right, how are you?
I'm doing good. So who do you have with you today?
This is my father, Eugene.
How you doing?
I'm doing fine, sir.
Well, nice to meet you. So I hear that you're battling with your health issues.
Yeah. I have a problem with my sugar diabetes. It just goes up and down.
Okay.
At least he doesn't have that yet.
Well, I'm glad to see you doing better.
Yeah.
All right, Aaron. So last time I saw you, you were 718. And you were supposed to lose 120 pounds in 2 months.
Yes, sir.
It's been 3 months, but today you're 696. You only lost 22 pounds in 3 months.
I'm struggling a little bit with what happened to my father. It was hard for me to deal with. And once he was recovering, I've been sticking to my diet as much as possible. I mean, I still have a little bit of problems with eating certain things, like peanut butter. I'm having a hard time staying with peanut butter. It's...
What do you mean, peanut butter?
Peanut butter on bread. It's just something that I like eating.
Peanut butter on bread is not what kept you from losing weight. Your excuse is that. I'm sorry what you all went through, but that's no excuse to have not done the diet. And on top of that, it's been 3 months. You still had 2 months, even after all that, to do what you're supposed to. But you didn't. What is with that?
I don't know, sir. I, you know.
What do you mean you don't know? You know exactly. You don't want to do the work, and you want to blame everything else for why you're not doing it. What's the point of that?
I don't know what to say, sir.
What is your expectation? You want us to do something for you to lose weight, but you continue doing whatever you were doing before?
No, I don't want to do
it. So how is that going to happen? How?
I'm going to change. I really am. I'm trying.
When are you going to change?
I'm in the process of changing, sir. I really am.
No, you're not. What we've given you is the first step to change. You either take it or you don't. The choice is up to you. You got it?
Yes, sir.
You know, for you to maintain weight of 696 pounds, you're still eating around 10,000 calories a day. That's not trying. That's not even close. So I'll give you 2 more months to lose 120 pounds. If you want to do this, then lose that weight. If you don't, then we don't need to waste more time playing games with you. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Who buys the peanut butter and bread?
I do.
My dad.
You buy it for him or you buy it for...
I buy it for the household, but you know what? I'm not going to buy no more.
Okay. And you shouldn't be eating that with your health care, okay?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
All right. This is your last chance, Aaron. You need to take this very seriously because the clock is ticking on you.
Yes, sir.
Okay?
Yes, sir.
All right. I'll see you in 2 months.
Thank you.
All right. You take care. It's very unfortunate that nothing changed with Aaron over the last 3 months. He's been given a chance to save his life, but he's still choosing to make excuses. And as sorry as I am, his father struggled with his health and that it was a scare for all of them, it doesn't change the fact that Aaron's body can't handle all the strain that his weight is putting on and for much longer. So if he doesn't start to drastically lose a significant amount of weight now, then he's not gonna be able to physically go on much longer and he's gonna die.
I'm really upset at myself, and I know I have to do better this time. And hearing Dr. Now say this is my last chance, it's absolutely terrifying. so no matter what, I'm gonna lose the weight I need and hit my goal
before my next appointment.
And I'm not making any more excuses or blaming anything else in my life. I know this is all up to me now, and I'm not gonna fail. There's too much at stake to let that happen.
For the past month, I've started working harder than I ever have to try and lose as much weight as possible before my next appointment with Dr. Now. To up my level of exercise and increase my activity, I joined a gym. And I'm going there 3 to 4 times a week to work out. At first, I was really intimidated, so it was hard to convince myself to start doing this. But I'm more worried about going back to see Dr. Now without having made it to my goal. The thought of that terrifies me far more than the thought of people staring at me or laughing at the big guy who can barely do much at this point. So I've looked up some exercises on the internet, and I've been coming here to work out for almost a full month now. I still can't do a whole lot, but I can do a good bit more than what I started. And every time I lift or do some reps, I push myself past the pain to go a little further. I used to see that pain as a problem or that I was pushing myself too hard. And after 5-10 minutes, I was ready to go. I didn't want to be here no more, but now I'm able to stay longer, do a lot more, and I have more energy to and not hurting as much. And every time I come to the gym, I push myself a little bit further just to see how much further I can go, how much more I can do. But now I see it as a limit I want to break. And I'm not afraid of it. So I'm happy with my progress with that